Would you like to know the most basic and most easily accomplished steps for lowering your fasting blood sugar? Insulin resistance typically means that your muscle cells have become clogged with intramyocellular fat, which reduces the ability of your insulin. This can leave glucose in your bloodstream, and that can lead to a cascade of unwanted medical issues. But here's the great news. There are tried and true dietary rules you can follow for improving your body's efficiency at burning glucose. Which foods and which nutrients should you regularly eat for increased insulin sensitivity? And what other steps outside of the kitchen should you take to reach your blood sugar balancing goals? Let's get right into it. These are 5 dietary rules that decrease insulin resistance. Number 5. Get antioxidants. Antioxidants are molecules that help prevent oxidative damage by neutralizing free radicals in your body. They include vitamins, like vitamins A, C, and D, minerals, like selenium and manganese, and other organic compounds, like beta-carotene and zeaxanthin. So getting these antioxidants as part of a balanced diet can work to reduce your risk of oxidative stress. Antioxidants also work to reduce inflammation, and both oxidative stress and inflammation are closely linked to insulin resistance. Plus, certain antioxidants have been found to directly affect glucose metabolism, and they can increase your body's efficiency of glucose uptake. But the power of antioxidants doesn't end there. They've also been shown to decrease harmful LDL cholesterol, triglycerides, systolic blood pressure, and BMI, which can all work to reduce insulin resistance. So, get antioxidants. Just be sure to eat a well-rounded diet with plenty of veggies, plus lean or plant-based protein, and appropriately sized servings of whole fruits. And you should gain all the antioxidants you'll need to help your body lower its insulin resistance. Number 4. Get good sleep. Your sleep patterns affect more than just your level of alertness. Adequate sleep improves your body's balance of its hormones and neurotransmitters, including the hormones ghrelin and leptin, which are directly related to how full you feel. So getting proper sleep can also work to keep cravings at bay, which can aid your weight management, which works to decrease insulin resistance. But on the flip side, sleep deprivation can increase levels of cortisol, a stress hormone, which can increase glucose levels and interfere with the body's ability to utilize insulin efficiently. Not getting enough sleep can also increase inflammation, which can increase the risk of developing type 2 diabetes. Meanwhile, did you know that poor sleep habits may lead to unhealthy food cravings? In fact, research shows that chronic lack of sleep can cause weight gain over time, as fatigue can lead you to seek out sugar-rich and saturated fat foods. But by getting good sleep, you will increase your energy and mental clarity, which can help you make better dietary choices while also improving your motivation for regular exercise. So, by getting 7 to 8 hours of sleep per night, you can set yourself up for increased weight loss, a lowered risk of developing type 2 diabetes, and improved insulin sensitivity. Number 3. Get soluble fiber. Fiber, in general, works in many ways to help you better manage your blood sugar. But soluble fiber, specifically, is recommended by nutritionists and doctors, as studies show it can slow the absorption of glucose in the bloodstream. Over time, getting proper amounts of this fiber can therefore work to reduce your body's insulin response, which decreases your insulin resistance. Soluble fiber increases satiety, which can help you avoid overeating and craving-induced snacking. This can help you to lose weight, which will also increase your insulin sensitivity. Research has also found that low levels of soluble fiber in the diet was associated with increased blood pressure and increased insulin levels. Fermentable soluble fiber, like beta-glucan, a type of fiber found in oats and barley, aids gut health by feeding your good gut bacteria. If you maintain a healthy gut microbiome, it can reduce obesity and diabetes-related inflammation. This can also work to improve your insulin sensitivity. Beta-glucan has also been found to lower cholesterol, reduce inflammation, and improve your blood sugar management. Plus, soluble fiber has also been found to decrease lipid levels, which can reduce your risk of developing type 2 diabetes. Number 2. Exercise. Many people turn to exercise as a means for losing weight. Still, the old trope that you can't exercise your way out of a bad diet is usually true. However, regularly exercising does work to improve your body's ability to burn carbohydrates, which essentially helps you to lose weight. Regularly exercising has been shown to reduce both visceral fat, or the excess abdominal fat which can develop around your organs, and intramyocellular fat, or the fat which can develop within your muscle cells. By decreasing this type of fat, your muscle cells will become more receptive to insulin, thus increasing your insulin sensitivity. So it's a large part of the reason that research shows that shedding fat, in general, can work to decrease insulin resistance. In fact, a Johns Hopkins University study showed that pre-diabetic participants who managed to lose 5-7% of their body weight over 6 months reduced their risk of chronic high insulin resistance, or type 2 diabetes, by over 50% over the following 3 years. Aerobic routines have been shown to improve your cardiovascular health. This can help your body to move blood through your system more efficiently, which works to reduce heart disease risk factors and other diseases related to insulin resistance. And studies show that postprandial exercise, which can simply mean taking a walk after lunch or dinner, can help to manage your post-meal blood sugar. Over time, regularly getting in even just 30-minute walks after your meals can work to improve your fasting blood sugar and your insulin sensitivity. But it's not just about getting in that cardio. Resistance training and weightlifting work to increase your muscle mass, and this too works to improve the efficiency of your insulin. Of course, losing weight has as much, if not more, to do with your eating habits than with exercising. But let's face it, you need some level of regular physical activity to aid your overall health, and it is an essential element for improved insulin sensitivity. What is the number one rule to follow for fighting insulin resistance? That's just ahead. But real quick, we want to give you 3 diabetes fighting gifts. The Super Book, Superfoods for Diabetics, Episode 1 of the Super Series, That Diabetes Documentary, and the Super Cookbook, Snacks, Meals, and Desserts That Lower Blood Sugar. Click the link in the description below to grab each of these guides to aid you on your quest for improved insulin sensitivity. Now, what is the very most important dietary rule for minimizing your insulin resistance? Number 1. Avoid processed carbs. Being diabetic means needing to be wary of carbohydrates. But there's more to the story. You need certain carbohydrates, in certain amounts. In fact, you'll get quality carb content from fruits, vegetables, and whole grains. But simple sugar, processed carb foods flood your system with glucose, but little to no fiber, and not much of any other nutritional value. Refined sugars and starches found in many processed, packaged foods, including chips, crackers, sodas, white breads, and even frozen meals, can spike your blood sugar. Regularly eating these simple carbs can also increase your fasting blood sugar and make your muscle cells less sensitive to insulin. And, of course, processed carb foods are also usually loaded with unhealthy saturated fats and oils, which can lead to weight gain, inflammation, and a decrease in your body's ability to burn glucose efficiently. And overall, these foods can heighten your insulin resistance. Plus, studies have shown that eating a diet high in processed carbohydrates can become addictive. The more you eat, the more your body craves the quick gratification of these simple sugars. That can lead to overeating these foods, thus increasing your risk of insulin resistance. On the flip side, eating quality carbohydrate content from natural sources, like vegetables, legumes, whole grains, and whole fruits, will supply fiber, antioxidants, and plenty of other nutritional benefits without spiking your blood sugar. So, now you know 5 dietary rules to follow for reducing your insulin resistance. What did you think? Which steps do you think are the most important for improving your insulin sensitivity? Comment below and let us know. Before you head out, don't forget to grab your 3 free gifts with the link below. Like, subscribe, and stay tuned to Diabetes Smarts for more informative content. And to give us a super thanks, we'd truly appreciate you clicking the thanks button. Thank you for watching. We hope you're having a happy and healthy day.